Well, this happens all the time.
Yes, it does. Jan.
Eleven.
Fuller.
I think.
Something like that.
Much better.
Much better.
They are closed, and they...
Anything else?
One diamond.
One diamond.
We have one diamond. We vote for one diamond.
Anyone give the scores?
Zero.
Zero.
Ten.
Number one. Why would it be a diamond instead of a spade?
So the vacant place, that's true.
I hope everybody can see that the past is not right. Your chances of setting this are nil. One note trump is wrong, that's very wrong. Because one note trump shows about 8 to 10 high card votes. The last time your party was here when they doubled is no trump. The reason they double is because they can support any suit. And their hand is worth more in a suit than it is in no trump. So the last time your party wanted to hear was no trump. Now why should you bet a diamond instead of a spade? Leave more room for your opponents to bet. When you have this and your partner's made a takeout double, what's the best thing that can happen to you? Have the opponents outbid you, right? Well, it's easier for your opponents to outbid you if you bet a diamond than if you bet a spade. That's why you should bet a diamond. Your partner's probably not going to bet it. But your partner's also less likely to raise diamonds because it takes five to make game than they are to raise spades. So one diamond is much better. I shouldn't say much better, but it's better. I mean, it is possible that you have a 3-3 diamond fed and a 4-3 spade. And if your partner only has 3 card support for one of these suits, it's more likely to be this. But this will also let you give them a better chance to outbid you and get you out of it, which is what you need. That's a little too good to bid one diamond.
Yeah. Especially if you bid one diamond on that other hand.
Especially if 3 hands earlier, you bid one diamond on the 3 to 10. So it's too good to bid one diamond. What you should bid is one no trump. Where do you think your most likely game is if you have a game?
No Trump.
No Trump, it's not in diamonds. And how are you going to get to no Trump when you bid diamonds? You think your partner's going to bid no Trump? They double because they don't have clubs. So the only way you're going to get to no Trump is for this hand to bid no Trump. And that one's good enough to bid one no Trump. That's what a one no Trump bid looks like. Should show a good 11 to 12, the 13, the bad 13. 13 is enough to bid 3 to 12. Is that a 2 no front bid after the double? That would be a 2 no trump bid. Two hearts has an upper limit to it. So if your hand is too strong, it'd be too hard. The upper limit would be that too.
Oh, really?
Make it level. And since there's an upper limit to it, if your hand, you can't do it with this. Your hand is too strong to be 2 hours.
Okay.
Because here, a jump, your partner doesn't have to be. A jump isn't forcing. It just shows a specific range. Jumping to the 2 level should show about 8 to 10. Jumping to the 3 level should show 9 to 11. So if you can hear one club double, 2 hearts would be about 8 to 10. That's total points, it's not accurate. Because you're playing in a suit. That's like the upper end of a 1 heart pass, 2 heart move. Okay, but look at the difference here. If we come back over here, let's say it was 1 spade. After the jump, you're betting what? 3 hearts. In a 2 heart bid after a spade double, this could be 0 points, couldn't it? But if you have to jump to the 3 level, this ought to be about 9 or 11 instead of when you can jump to the 2 level. Could be 8 to 10. More than this or more than this. So if you have more than that, then you have to cube it. Or get down.
Does a cubit say that you've got the opening suit?
No. It says nothing about the opening suit. You might have it, or if you don't find a 4-4 fit, if you cube bid, your partner should bid their cheapest 4-card suit.
Not the major necessarily.
The cheapest 4-card suit. Just like your opening response. With 4-card suits, you would be cheapest. So,
you don't do the 2 clubs.
You bet 2 clubs when you're not sure where it was.
Okay.
In other words, it's kind of like when your partner opens an Ultra, you should ask yourself where you belong. And if you know where you belong, you go there. If you don't know where you belong, then you ask questions. Right? Are you staying there? Are you transferring? Are you good to the Ultra? But you try to find that. Okay, if your partner makes a takeout double, are you sure you belong to those guys? So here's your cube. If you find a spade fit, you belong to four spades. If you don't, you belong to three knuckles. So the cubits are more when you're not sure where you belong. Over a double, you should keep it in, because you can either belong in four spades, four hearts, or three no clubs. And if your partner's double one club, it's very unlikely that they don't have good cards. But you don't know which one, right? So you don't know where you belong. So you would keep it in. Now if your partner gets hearts, you need four hearts. If it's spades, you need four spades. You're cubiting because you don't know where to go. And you need that. Now you know where to go, so you need four spades. Right. Over the double, you just get four spades. You don't have to ask any questions.
Well, I'm glad that he didn't sell it.
Okay, so in general, after the takeout double, a one no trump response is about 8 to 10 high card. Jumping in a suit, if you can jump in a two level, it's 8 to 10.
Well,
you should have it stop. You should try to have a chance to stop it twice. Not necessarily can always stop it twice, but a chance to stop it twice. And if you have a choice between bidding a minor and bidding no turn, you want to bid no turn. You have a choice between bidding spades and no trump, bid spades. Okay, so after a double, a jump in the three level is 9 and 11, and a jump in the two level is 8 to 10, and no trump is 8 to 10.
After the double, say you just have a
No. You can't ever be a no trump with three
of
those.
Okay. So you just say your footprint.
Just bid your cheapest suit.
Okay.
You want one of these?
A no trump has a lower limit of about 8 high card points. Now, if you don't have a better bid and you think it's a good 7, you might shave it down to 7. If your other choices are better. But in general, it's your choice. jumping into two levels, it was 8-10. Total. Jumping into three levels, so 9-11 total. And each cubit, like one club doubling, two clubs. Nobody can pass until one person lays his hand or you get together. So you have to have, to do this, you have to have a place to have to invite them. At least enough to invite them. Or if your partner raises, then you can pass. But it's not forcing all of it again. It's forcing until one person raises the other. So, one club, double, two clubs, two arms. This one can't pass two arms. Two spells. This one can't pass two spells. Now this one can pass. So the three spade then would be a miracle to take out the Okay? Yeah. We still got some.